Nearly 50 years ago, Cedars-Sinai Chief of Pediatrics Ben Feingold published heresy, suggesting that artificial food colors could induce behavioral disturbances. Dow Chemical disagreed, as did Coca-Cola, as well as other players within the trillion-dollar processed food industry, who were able to convince the medical establishment that it was all just one elaborate placebo effect. But the truth can only be buried so long. In 2004, a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled food challenge was published. Hyperactivity in preschoolers was significantly reduced when artificial colorings in the preservative sodium benzoate were eliminated from their diets. But hyperactivity jumped back up when the additives, rather than a placebo, were reintroduced into their diets. The researchers suggest the benefit would accrue for all children if they didn't consume artificial food colors or benzoate preservatives. Then another randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled food challenge was published in probably the most prestigious medical journal in the world. This time, researchers found that artificial colors and other food additives in processed foods appeared to exacerbate hyperactive behaviors, impulsivity, inattentiveness, and overactivity among young children, with more pronounced effects in 3-year-olds relative to 8- or 9-year-olds. And indeed, a more recent randomized control trial in 8- or 9-year-olds in Hong Kong didn't observe a significant effect. The author suggested it may be because older kids may be less sensitive, or the dose used was too small relative to what the kids typically consumed. But what happens in children already diagnosed with ADHD if you remove artificial food colors? In a meta-analysis of randomized controlled trials for dietary interventions for ADHD, excluding artificial food colors from the diet significantly improved behavior. In this meta-analysis, the data over here suggests that food colors were harmful, whether assessed by parents, observers, or attention tests, compared to studies showing the opposite. You can actually see the difference in brain waves on EEG compared to placebo. As I highlighted years ago, the European Union requires warning labels of potential adverse effects on activity and attention in children. However, though the Food and Drug Administration in the United States has banned a few artificial colors like red dye number 1, red dye number 2, red dye number 4 due to cancer concerns, no warning labels are required, and many artificial colors still predominate processed foods. Among grocery store products marketed to children, about 40% contain at least one artificial color. In 2021, a report from the California Environmental Protection Agency highlighted the potential neurobehavioral effects of artificial food dyes in children. The authors concluded that although not all studies implicated them, the current medical literature provides a substantial amount of evidence that consumption of synthetic food dyes is associated with adverse neurobehavioral outcomes in kids, and the FDA's acceptable daily intake levels may not adequately protect children. For years, I've been concerned that red number 3 still hasn't been banned from food, given that it was banned more than 30 years ago from inclusion in any products that go on our skin due to cancer risk. Finally, in October 2023, the California Food Safety Act was signed, banning red dye number 3 from foods and drinks sold in California, while consumer groups like the Center for Science and the Public Interest continued to petition the FDA for a national ban to prohibit use of this carcinogen. And on January 15, 2025, 35 years after it was banned in cosmetics, FDA finally banned it nationwide, in food as of 2027, and in drugs as of 2028.